Pete Rose from WrestleMania 14, WrestleMania 15, and WrestleMania 2000. What was originally supposed to be a one-spot deal turned into a three-year angle of sorts with Pete Rose at WrestleMania. Pete Rose was the guest ring announcer for the Undertaker-Kane match at 14, but proceeded just to make fun of Boston, calling them a bunch of losers, and if you know anything about baseball, Pete Rose and the Cincinnati Reds beat the Boston Red Sox in the 1975 World Series. He ripped Boston a new one, and then Kane made his entrance and tombstoned Pete Rose. Now, if this was just a one-off deal, it wouldn't have meant anything. But again, Rose wasn't done. At WrestleMania 15 during Kane's entrance, the San Diego Chicken attacked Kane. Kane fought the chicken and took the head off, and it was Pete Rose. Kane gave Rose the tombstone yet again. The following year at WrestleMania 2000, during the post-match with Kane and Rikishi, the San Diego Chicken shows up again. Kane and everybody thought it was Pete Rose, but then the real Pete Rose tried sneaking up with a ball bat, ended up with a choke slam and a sting face for his troubles. What was supposed to be just a one-spot deal turned into a three-year angle that was hilarious. Floyd Mayweather Jr. from WrestleMania 24. Now, say what you will about Mayweather, but what he did at WrestleMania 24 with Big Show was outstanding. Easily one of the best celebrity versus wrestler matches of all time. Mayweather had just retired for the first time from boxing in 2007 after the Ricky Hatton fight. Mayweather was at the apex of his career at this point. So for WrestleMania, WWE decided they were going to do something with Mayweather. Big Show was coming back after over a year off, so why not do biggest versus best? The biggest athlete in the world, Big Show, versus the best athlete in the world, Floyd Mayweather Jr. They set this up in Las Vegas at No Way Out. Big Show made his return. He taunted Mayweather by going after Rey Mysterio. Mayweather jumped the barricade and in the process landed a bunch of punches to Big Show's face, breaking Big Show's nose. And according to Big Show, he told Mayweather to break his nose in order to get the angle going. Now, Mayweather was positioned as the babyface, Big Show was positioned as the heel. However, the fans just said fuck that and made Mayweather the heel and Big Show the face. Like I said before, as far as celebrity versus wrestler matches goes, it's easily one of the best ones in history. Match went almost 12 minutes. Mayweather won by knockout via brass knuckles. They got a spot on SportsCenter with this match. Again, say what you will, but Floyd Mayweather Jr. at WrestleMania 24 was outstanding. Cyndi Lauper from WrestleMania, the original celebrity of the WWF. The whole rock and wrestling connection really got its start with Cyndi Lauper and her music video for Girls Just Wanna Have Fun with Captain Lou Albano in it. Lauper would be in the corner of Wendy Richter at the Brawl to End It All and the War to Settle the Score, and would also be in her corner at the first WrestleMania. The feud started with Lauper and Albano, but then it transitioned to Lauper and Fabulous Moolah after Richter beat Moolah for the Women's Championship at Brawl to End It All. Moolah was in the corner of Leilani Kai when Kai took the title off Richter at War to Settle the Score. You had the rematch at the first WrestleMania with Cyndi Lauper being in the corner of Wendy Richter taking on Leilani Kai with Fabulous Moolah in her corner. Lauper's impact makes her deserving of a spot on here. She got people that weren't wrestling fans hooked in and got those people to see the first WrestleMania. Now, I'll be honest here. I'm not the biggest supporter of the celebrity wing of the WWE Hall of Fame, but if anyone deserves a spot in it, it's Cyndi Lauper. Mr. T from WrestleMania and WrestleMania 2. The other major celebrity of the first WrestleMania was one of the major focal points of the first WrestleMania main event. Now, Mr. T was one of the biggest celebrities at that time. He was the star of the A-Team, he was just a couple years removed from Rocky III, amongst other things. Mr. T was a huge star. And it was perfect to pair one of the biggest stars in Hollywood with the biggest star in pro wrestling. You pair Mr. T with Hulk Hogan and it was gonna be successful. At war to settle the score, Mr. T got involved in the post-match melee after the Hogan-Piper WWF Championship match, and at this point, an alliance between Mr. T and Hulk Hogan was formed. At the first WrestleMania, it would be Hulk Hogan and Mr. T versus Roddy Piper and Paul Orndorff in the main event. This was easily one of the biggest and most important matches in WrestleMania history. As said many times before, the first WrestleMania was a huge gamble for Vince McMahon. If it failed, who knows where the business would be today. Luckily, it succeeded, the match was great, and the rest is history. Now, if it was just that, if WrestleMania 1, Mr. T would probably be number one, if that was just it. However, WrestleMania 2 happened. Now, granted, the Mr. T Roddy Piper boxing match was one of the big attractions for WrestleMania 2. However, it ended up being one of the worst matches in WrestleMania history. Piper has called it the worst match of his entire career. Now, despite the match itself, the attraction of the boxing match and the star power of the first main event, Mr. T's importance to the first two WrestleManias set the tone for celebrities for years to come at WrestleMania. Mike Tyson from WrestleMania 14. Arguably one of the best investments in WWF/WWE history. Tyson's involvement at WrestleMania 14 was the rebirth of the WWF. Because for the better part of that decade, the WWF had fallen on hard times. Several scandals, wrestlers leaving, attendance dropping, revenue dropping, pay-per-view buys dropping, and with WCW coming into prominence starting in 1994, WWF was not in good shape. They needed something. So starting in late 1997, they were gonna go edgier with their product. However, that wasn't enough. They needed one thing to get people watching. People started watching. There was one thing missing. Enter Mike Tyson, one of the greatest boxers in history and one of the most controversial sports figures of the entire decade. Tyson was going to be a part of WrestleMania 14, and what better star to be associated with than Stone Cold Steve Austin. Austin versus Tyson on Raw is one of the greatest segments in WWF/WWE history. That set the tone for WrestleMania and set the tone for the WWF going forward. Tyson was going to be the special guest enforcer for the Michaels-Austin WWF Championship match, and also during this point, Tyson joined DX. However, it was all a ruse as Tyson fast counted three and Austin became the new WWF champion. Tyson was needed for this WrestleMania. It drew 730,000 pay-per-view buys, which at that time was the most buys in WrestleMania history. It had outdrawn the previous two WrestleManias combined. That's right, WrestleMania 12 and 13 drew horrible buys. WrestleMania 14 outdrew 12 and 13 combined. And that little $3 million investment for Mike Tyson, The WWF has since made that money back tenfold. And the most important thing of all, Mike Tyson helped launch Stone Cold Steve Austin. And the rest, as they say, is history.